Today, lecture 2 of Basic Electronics is PN Junction Diode Part 2. So today our topic is about PN Junction. Here PN Junction has three subtopics, that is forward biasing, reverse biasing and characteristics of VI. So today we will begin with our first topic, that is forward biasing. So now first let the statement of the forward biasing. Okay, so see. A junction diode is said to be forward biased. See, whenever a junction is said to be diode, only if it has two terminal, right? Diode have to have two terminal, one positive and one negative. When these two terminal are connected to the battery, we will have the biasing, okay? So, see, when the positive terminal of the external battery is connected to the P side. See, in the P side we know that it's the majority of holes and minority of the electrons. So whenever this P side is connected to the positive terminal of the battery and negative terminal to the N side of the diode, that is the N diode, which is the majority of electrons and minority of holes, and it has a negative side, is N type is connected to the negative terminal of the battery, then this is the forward biasing of the PN junction. So now we will know about the flow of current in forward biasing. Let's read. The forward voltage opposes the potential barrier, due to which the potential barrier decreases and depletion layer decreases. So let's now read this one. When we apply voltage, there will be the voltage drop at the depletion layer, which lead to a barrier to the potential. Basically, this 2 points says that whenever we apply voltage, let it be V, to this forward biased PN junction, then we know that this depletion layer, when that is the N type, which is the majority of the electrons, some electrons moves to the P type and majority of the holes in the P type, some holes moves to the N type, right? And that means when the holes have moved to the N type, that means it will be positive there, and when the electron moves, then it will be negative, right? Which causes the depletion layer. So that means whenever there will be a depletion layer, there will be a changes, a difference in the charges, right? So that charges is the potential difference, and that only give us the depletion layer. Whenever we apply this voltage, then the depletion layer give us the voltage drop, and that means it gives us a potential barrier. Now let's, when we increase the voltage, depletion layer gets narrower at a voltage, it ceases to exist. Out of the hole, an electron to produce the hole moves towards the junction and the electron moves towards the junction, and hence, see, basically it says that whenever we apply voltage to this PN junction, which is forward biased, then this depletion layer becomes narrower, and at a such a point, let it be 0.7, it doesn't exist, okay? And as the holes is in the positive side, so it will ripple, and the negative side, that is the electron, will is connected to a negative side, so it will ripple. So both of them changes its size, electron moves to the P type and holes moves to the N type, right? That only is saying that whenever the voltage is applied, that the depletion layer becomes narrower and narrower. This is the basic 4 point of flow of current. Now let's read that the flow of current of the holes and the holes and the electrons across opposite direction. Both are moving in the opposite direction, so there will be a flow of current, right? And this current is called forward current and is constituted by the motion of majority carriers across the junction. See, this is the current which is known as forward current, because they both are having the majority of the holes as well as the electrons. Okay, and the last point is that in this, the junction diode offers low resistance. Always remember, this junction diode offers low resistance. And basically, all these points are the flow of current in forward biasing. So now we will view on the reverse biasing. Okay, a junction diode is said to be reverse biased when the positive terminal of the external battery is connected to the N side of the diode and negative terminal to the P side of the diode. Basically, we know that diode must have two terminals, one negative and one positive, and we know that and both of them here are in the opposite direction. And we know that p-type is a majority of holes and minority of electrons, and here and the n-type is a majority of electrons and the minority of holes. Whenever the p-type is connected to a negative terminal of the battery and the n-type is connected to the positive terminal of the battery, then these two charges are in the different form, and this is the reverse biasing. That is that one will be minus and other will be plus. Both are in the opposite direction, just the opposite of the forward biasing. Okay, so this is basically reverse biasing. Now we will have a look on the flow of current in reverse bias. We know that reverse biasing is what? When the p-type is connected to the negative terminal of the battery and the n-type is connected to the positive terminal of the battery, right? So now see, there are few statements for the flow of current in the reverse biasing, and so let's read it first. Okay, in this situation, the reverse voltage supports the potential barrier, due to which the potential barrier increases and depletion layer increases. When we increase the voltage, there is no voltage drop in the depletion layer, and the potential barrier increases as well as depletion layer. See, basically we know that the p-type is a majority of holes and minority of electrons, and n-type is the majority of electrons and the minority of holes. So the p-type is positive and it is connected to a negative, so it will attract each other. So that means it will move in the opposite direction, that is it will move in the left side. See, as I am marking. And similarly, n-type is the majority of the electrons, so negative and positive will attract each other, so it will move in the right direction. So this will create the depletion layer. So whenever we apply the voltage, so there will be no voltage drop. And we know that the p-type, some holes are moved to the n-type and some electrons are moved to the p-type, which have created this depletion layer due to the positive and the negative charges. And so whenever we apply this voltage, there will be no voltage drop and the depletion layer will becoming thicker and thicker. If this depletion layer would have been thinner, then only there will be the flow of current whenever we apply this voltage in this junction. And here we know that, okay, both holes and the electrons move away from each other and there is almost no current flow due to majority charge carrier. See, as the holes are moving in the opposite direction and the electrons are moving in the opposite direction, so there is no current flow, because there is always the current flow is happening due to this majority charge carriers, right? So there will be no current flow. Now see, at some point there will be a voltage breakdown and there will be a reverse increase in current. Okay, see, at some point, let that be any point, this is the main fact of the reverse biasing, is that it will increase at a point, that the current will increase, but that point will be known as the voltage breakdown. At that point there will be a voltage breakdown which will do, okay, a very small current due to minority charge carriers flows through the junction. This current is called reverse current. See, this is the current is known as reverse current, because there is a very small current flowing due to the minority. Minority means p-type for electrons and n-type for holes, right? So this is the flow of current in reverse bias. Basically, reverse bias is just the opposite of the forward bias. In forward biasing, we see that the depletion layer becomes thinner and thinner, which causes the flow of current, and in reverse bias it's the opposite, that is it becoming thicker and thicker. So basically this is the major difference between the flow of current between forward biasing and reverse biasing, and hence we come to the end of the lecture of this PN junction diode. Now is the cool time, falsehood takes the place of truth when it results in unblemished common good. I think all of you understood today's lecture, and thank you for watching.
Wow, that's impressive! You have completed a magic today. For more videos, subscribe! Join our Facebook group and Instagram page for group discussion and live magazine videos for exam preparation in an hour. We start a class like community for students to learn from a friend in a simple way and support them in their own languages. If you are willing to be that one friend who saves us at the exam night preparation, then please join us by visiting classfly.in.